no timeouts. Chance to be a hero. Or we're going to play five more. For the win, it's Jack McVay.
For two more, 8.1 seconds.
Whoa,
in front of the leg. Problem. Doyle kept it in. Here's the Jack Jumpers chance. McVay, two on the clock.
Oh,
Jack McVay.
Oh.
Simply incredible. Jack McVay with the shot of his life. Tasmania win game three and silence Melbourne.
0.7 seconds remaining.
Yep.
McDonald inbound.
Oh, my.
What a star. He was the MVP of what has to be the greatest grand final series in NBL history. Jack McVay, welcome. Congratulations.
Thank you very much for having me
so
here.
Good. I had several other questions I was going to begin with, but just watching that game three, that half-court shot, buzzer beater, how many times have you relived that since that moment?
Well, it was interesting hitting it because the first kind of emotion that went through is, don't waste this opportunity. We've got to win this thing. Then that night, you know, I went back and then I watched it probably 100 times. But for me, it was really watching the reaction of all my teammates. You know, like Will Magne was there, his face was going crazy. Dudes were tackling me, grabbing, you know, pulling me. And then moved on. And then I would be lying if I said the last couple of weeks I haven't, you know, here and there, chucked it on and watched it a couple of times.
It is absolutely amazing.
Jack, that whole final series, though, one of the best final series in any sport, game four that you lose at home must have been disappointing, but how bloody pumped were you for the group that managed to go to Melbourne and win game five and win the series?
Yeah, I mean, we were pretty defeated after that game four. We were up five with 2 minutes to go and we thought, those emotions start to kick in, like, wow, we can do this. We can win at home, 5,000 people going crazy. And a couple turnovers, moods down, but we had to lock in. We go into Melbourne, and what we were saying is this is how we want to get it done, the most difficult way, go into Melbourne, which, you know, a lot of people call the heartland of basketball in Australia, which it rightfully probably is, and go in there and win in game five.
What about the other moment? Because you had that phenomenal moment, game three. Game five, we just saw it there. Dellavedova has his shot. Now, was there... when you were standing on court, did time kind of stand still as this was happening as the ball was going through the air? What was going through your head then?
Well, if you want to give a kid a heart attack, that's how... that's how the series went. It wouldn't have been a surprise if it went in. Mm. And then I remember just turning around, watching it, looking at it, kind of, you know, bank off the backboard to a miss, and took me a moment, you know? It was a couple of seconds of like, oh, did we actually just win this game? Like, did the siren just go? And you can kind of see everyone there.
Did you just do it for the island?
I tell you what, they traveled, there's 2,000 fans there going crazy. And, yeah, it took a moment and still kind of pinching myself that we managed to get it done.
Well, tell us about that, because you said Tassie went nuts, didn't you? Like, you're an absolute superstar, legend status in Tassie right now.
Oh, it was pretty crazy. I mean, after game three, hitting that shot, we land in Hobart and there's a mural of me in the city, which was crazy. Yeah, so there's this mural. And if you watch the interview...
How long did it take you to put up?
I landed early, spray painting. I was working hard. You know? Had my sister. My sister does some art, so we were in the backyard practicing. But nah, so that was crazy. So I get there, I'm looking at my big ugly mug, you know, on the side of a wall. And then the last couple of weeks has been, you know, wild. My roommate, we go to Woolies and there's big blow-up heads, you know, at the front. And you can't escape it. It's been crazy
Jack, I need to ask you, because I read an article. The headline was, ice showers, cigars and bare chests. Now, this is a hell of a party down in Tasmania, but I wanted to ask you about Jordan Crawford, who had an amazing game five. Rumours are that he is related to Floyd Mayweather. Now, I know you get your rings when you win the NBA, but with the NBL, but apparently you guys were going to get other gifts. What did you hear about this?
Yeah, so, you know, we jump on the FaceTime every now and then with Floyd and act like we're pretty big time, but I heard there was a rumour that we might get a watch here or there, but, you know, I sent him my address and we'll see what happens in the next couple of days. So, Crawford, if you're watching.
So you've been talking to Floyd Mayweather?
Oh, I would say sitting in the background saying, oh, my God, it's Floyd. If we say that's talking to, then, yeah, we've been having some great chats.
Yeah. Now, Jackie, the smiling assassin, we've spotlighted this trade of yours before you have a free throw. You deliberately break out of this most beautiful smile. Talk us through it.
Yeah, well, for me, I played college basketball for 3 years and I went over there and kind of really struggled mentally on the court. I would train well, get into games, and it was tough. I would miss easy shots and kind of never perform. Stress got to me. I studied psychology over there to try and help it. And one of the things I read was about a study where smiling helped relax the body, calmed you down. And so I gave it a go when my free throws were struggling when I joined the NBL. And here we are, 6 years later, performing under pressure, smiling at the free throw line and trying not to freak out there the whole time.
Amazing tactic. I'm surprised it's not more widely used, to be honest.
I think there actually is one guy in the rugby league, I think, that does it when he's kicking goals. So maybe it could be the start of a new trend.
Wow. And, Jack, if you look at what you've done, it's been an amazing year. And what you did, you went to Melbourne, not against all the odds, but certainly, you know, Melbourne would have fancied themselves. But looking forward, there's so much for you to look forward. We're talking just off air about what's coming ahead, Paris. With the Boomers, so...
Yeah, I mean, that's the goal, right? That's every kid's dream, is to go to the Olympics, represent Australia. And the Boomers right now are a team where if you're playing for it, you've got a chance to medal. Mm. And so right now they just announced the 22-man squad. They'll get cut to 12 with the camp in early July. And, you know, sport's a beautiful thing. There's always that fine line of being satisfied and enjoying the journey, but then chasing what's next. And I won the finals MVP. Two days later, we get the Boomers call up. Awesome. And it's back to work, back to chasing dreams.
It's a purple patch.
The purple patch.
Tell us how, like, just tell everyone, though, how hard it is, because you said the squad's, the 12 is peaked for the Olympics, but 10 guys come back from the NBA for that. So there's two spots left.
Pretty much. I mean, you're always competing. Doesn't guarantee you a spot if you're in the NBA, but they're playing in the best league in the world, and there's going to be a lot of good basketball players competing for that spot, but...
So what are you doing at the moment? What are you doing at the moment since that's happened? Obviously, there's been a few parties, we would imagine. But, well, what do you do?
The parties weren't too crazy, you know? It's not like these stories of the old school days. I don't drink during the season, so I had 3 or 4 beers after the game and I was drunk. You know, I was on the dance floor telling people how much I love them. You know,
I love you, bro. Floyd.
Where's the watch?
Steve, get this idiot out of here.
Cheap drunk.
But, you know, a week off and then it was straight back into it, in the weight room. You know, I'm still trying to get stronger and putting on those muscles, so...
You mentioned college. You play with the Cornhuskers, which is a terrific name, but the Jack Jumpers is also terrific. Now, do you know much about this very small but very nasty and venomous ant that leaps at people and potentially kills them?
Well, I did some minor landscaping in my backyard this year, and so they're definitely around. They're definitely dangerous. I remember the first year I moved to Tasmania, and we're there. We go in, we get our heart checked, do all the health stuff before a season. 5 of us walk in and they thought we were there for a Jack Jumper program for ant bites. Doing studies. They had never heard of the Jack Jumpers. They didn't know who we were. The lovely lady working on me looks at me and goes, oh my gosh, you guys are the tallest people I've ever seen. What a coincidence. I said, no, we're here to play basketball. They hadn't heard about us. And here we are 3 years later.
She knows who you are now.
I think so.
The entire nation knows who you are, and even better since you've been on this show. Thank you so much and congratulations. Brilliant work.
Thanks for having me, guys.
What a champion. Speaking of which, coming up, our champ of the week. Stick around.
Yes. Hold on.